Very good morning, children. So this is module number 4, subject physics, class talk. And today I'm going to do a few questions which came in the previous years CBC board examinations, so that you can recap all that has been taught to you from chapter 1. So in chapter 1 we learned about charge. We learned about electrostatic force of attraction or repulsion. We learned about electric field arising from a point charge. Electric field due to a infinitely long uniformly charged conductor. And electric field due to an infinitely long plane sheet which is uniformly charged. And then electric field due to a hollow spherical shell. Yeah, a spherical shell. So these are the things we learned, and we learned about flux, and we learned about Gauss law, and these were actually the application of Gauss law. So here we have few questions. The first question is, a point charge 10 microcoulomb. Positive 10 is at a distance 5 centimeter directly above the center of a square of side 10 centimeter as shown in figure. What is the magnitude of the electric flux through the square? So what is the magnitude of electric flux through the square? So it is given, a square is given here. So I'm doing it in 3D. So it's like a rhombus, but it is square. 3D appearance लाने के लिए, क्योंकि इसमें इसका आंसर करने के लिए 3D appearance का कुछ फिगर बनाना ही पड़ेगा. So from its center, there's a point charge 10 microcoulomb. So, इसका 3D appearance के लिए ऐसा करा गया है ताकि आपको समझ में आए कि एक कागज है या एक शीट है, एक स्क्वायर है, और उस स्क्वायर के बिल्कुल 5 सेंटीमीटर ऊपर 5 सेंटीमीटर की डिस्टेंस में, जैसे इसमें रखा है 5 सेंटीमीटर की डिस्टेंस में एक चार्ज है. सो ये एक शीट है और इससे 5 सेंटीमीटर डिस्टेंस में यहाँ पे एक चार्ज करना है. सो दैट्स अ क्वेश्चन एंड फाइंड द फ्लक्स थ्रू दिस सर्फेस. सो वी ऑलरेडी नो द गॉस लॉ. व्हाट इज गॉस लॉ? The flux through a surface, a closed surface, is equal to Q enclosed by the surface divided by epsilon. But here you must have a closed surface. So a point charge 10 microcoulomb is at a distance 5 cm directly above the center of a square of side 10 cm as shown in the figure. What is the magnitude of the electric flux through the square? So what is electric flux here? So in order to find electric flux, we have Gauss law. By Gauss law, flux is equal to Q enclosed upon epsilon, but Q enclosed by the 3D surface. Gauss law, you have to assume a 3D Gaussian surface here, but here is just a 2D surface. इसको 3D बनाने के लिए आप इसको एक क्यूब का पार्ट मानो. तो इसको क्यूब का पार्ट मानेंगे तो ऐसा कुछ आप एक डायग्राम बना सकते हैं. सो एक डायग्राम बन जाएगी. सो इट्स अ क्यूब ये, और ये क्यूब का वन ऑफ द साइड है ये स्क्वायर जो है गिवन है. सो ये जो स्क्वायर है इससे आप इमेजिन कर सकते हैं कि उस स्क्वायर में बहुत 5 स्क्वायर्स और आ गया तो एक क्यूब बन गया. तो अब इसका इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स थ्रू द एंटायर स्क्वायर हमें पता है क्यू अपॉन एप्सिलॉन. तो सिर्फ एक साइड से क्या होगा? टोटल कितना साइड है भाई? 6. So there are total 6 arcs here. So flux through one phase, one of the phase is equal to 1 upon 6 into Q upon epsilon 1. Or 1 upon 6 into what is Q? Q is already given here, 10 microcoulomb. 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb divided by epsilon naught, 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And you calculate this, you will get the answer 1 upon 6, 4, so 24, 2, 6, 5, so 30, 30, 2, 3. 6 8 is 48, 48 plus 3, 51, 5. 6 8 is 48 plus 5, 53. Into 10 to the power minus 5, actually it is minus 6 plus 1 or minus plus 12, because the minus 12 will go up. So the total electric field is 1 upon 53.124 into 10 to the power minus plus 7 it will be, 10 to the power plus 7. So you divide it to get the answer, and when you divide it you will get almost like 1.88 into 10 to the power, because you can multiply it 100. So 53, 2 times 100, so it will be like almost 1.88 if you calculate it properly, into 10 to the power minus 2 will be here, so minus 2 and 10 to the power plus 7, it will become 10 to the power 5 newton meter square coulomb minus 1. So this is the final answer. So we go to the next question. So there are two, the second question is, there are two metal plates tightly held against each other, they are just very close. Metal plates tightly held against each other means they are very, they are in close contact with each other. And question is, what will happen to the plates? Happen to the plates when they are released. And the second question is, draw the pattern of electric field lines for the system. So when they are in very close contact with each other, there is no excess charge on them, because equal number of protons and electrons are there. If you take a metal, and the metal by itself is actually neutral. So, but because of this positive charge, all the negative charges, even from P2, will come over here and arrange themselves to the side of the positive charge, and all the, it means the positive charges here, the atoms, they lost some electrons, it means here is a net positive charge. So electron will repel, and the positive charge will attract. So like opposite charge attract, like charge repel. Because of that, the electrons, you know, moved from, yeah, the negative charges moved to the P1 plate. And now if you just remove them, the P1 will have only excess negative charges, and P2 will have excess positive charge because of lack of electrons and because of excess of electrons here. And minus Q is here, plus Q is here. So earlier they were very closely held, but now they are a little bit at a distance apart, they are relaxed. And now what is the electric field lines over here? Draw the pattern of electric field lines. So the first answer is already there, where it will, you know, a charge will be induced. That is the first answer for the first question. What will happen to the plates? Because what will happen to the plates? The answer is the plates will have some excess charge when they are removed. And the second question is, draw the pattern of the electric field lines for the system. So you can draw the patterns like this. For positive charge, the pattern will be like this. And for the negative charge, the pattern will be like this. Because for positive charge, the electric field line starts from the positive charge and ends in the negative charge. And here also, you will get a pattern like this. So this is how. The electric field lines appear for the system given. So that's the answer for the second question. So this is a question given. Electric field is given Kx and cylinder with a height 2a and radius a. So height is 2a and the radius is a. So the question is, net electric flux through the cylinder. So in order to find the electric flux, we have a formula, the closed integral E dot dE. So closed integral, in a sense, it the limits are not here, because when we say about a closed surface, there is no beginning, no end, it's everywhere. Where you start, you have to come back again. So closed integral, and there are three different surfaces. I'm going to name it like A1, A2 and A3. So I can split this integral to be E dA1 cos theta, and cos theta will be 180 here, E dA2 or cos 0, E dA3 cos 90. Why this cos 180? Because area is in this direction, electric field is in this direction. And why is 0? Because area is in this direction, electric field is also in this direction. And why is 90? Because electric field is in the direction, but the area is perpendicular, cos 90. So here you get E into area is pi r square. And this is minus. So r square is a square here. And here the electric field intensity is also variable, because it is depending on x. So we will write E1, E2, E3. If electric field intensity has no x, no variable, only constants, then you can simply write E. So E1 pi a square plus E2 pi a square, because cos 0 is 1, and plus 0 because cos 90 is 0. So if you calculate this, you will get E is equal, flux is equal to E2 minus E1 into pi E square. So E was already given like Kx I cap. So the magnitude is Kx. So x is here A for the first. So E1 is actually Ka, but E2 is K into E2 is here, so the distance is A, 2A, 3A. So 3KA minus KA into pi A square. And your final answer here comes 2KA into pi A square. So 2K pi A cube is a net electric flux, Newton meter square column minus 1. Is a net electric flux, and pi is 3.14, but k is a constant and non-quantity, so even you can keep the pi as it is. And now, the second question was, what is the net electric charge? Because if there is a flux, then there must be a charge. So what is the charge there? By Gauss law, you already know. By Gauss law, flux is equal to Q enclosed upon epsilon naught. So the second question is actually, what is a Q enclosed here? So Q enclosed is equal to flux into epsilon naught. So you'll get the final answer, 2k pi epsilon naught aq. So here also we are not going for the numerical calculation, because here many things are already variables. A is a variable, means the value of A is not given, value of K is not given. So value of pi and epsilon naught is not necessary to be put in this equation to find the actual value. Okay, so let's go for the next question, question number 4. So this type of question is an important question, because it is flux, related to flux, and related to flux, the whole chapter has more weightage on electric field and flux. Okay, so two parallel uniformly charged infinite plane sheets 1 and 2 have charge densities plus sigma and minus 2 sigma respectively. Give the magnitude and direction of net electric field at a point number 1 between two sheets, number 2 outside of outside but near to sheet 1. So here are two sheets given, sheet number 1, sheet number 2, which has a charge density plus sigma and which has a charge density minus 2 sigma. Minus means it has a negative charge anyway. So what is a electric field? So here in the diagram it is shown like a line, but it is actually an infinitely plane sheet. This is also an infinite plane sheet. So what is the net electric field? What is the total electric field at the point between the two sheets and outside near sheet 1? So this is a question. So let's do the question. Let's solve it. So the positive charge has electric field line. Positive charge has electric field line always outwards. And the negative charge as electric field line always, what? Inwards. So I'm going to make it a bigger one, so that you can differentiate, the electric field due to the first one and second one. So this is due to the first one, but this is due to the second one. And this is also due to the first one, but this is due to the second one. So due to all these positive charges, we have load of field lines going like this, outwards and outwards. But all these negative charges, it is inward and inward. So what about inward. So what about this area? First, you have to find the first is actually between the two planes. So between two plates, what? How do you find electric field? Between two plates. So between two plates here, this is a between two plates, and both electric field lines are in the same direction. So what you have to write is, what is a formula actually for an infinite plane sheet? Sigma upon 2 epsilon naught and n cap perpendicularly away from the sheet. So So that is a formula we have already derived. So here, due to the first plane, we will write sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, or it is downwards. So this one is also downwards. So sigma, it is minus 2 sigma, but you will not write minus. You will still write 2 sigma, because electric field is a vector quantity, and the minus has something to do with the direction only. So already we are keeping the direction in mind. So you don't, you have to write only the magnitude here. Plus, and the direction is downwards. Even you can write j cap, but here I am writing downwards according to the diagram. So the final answer is this for the first part. And the second part is outside near plate number 1. So this is plate number 1, and outside is this area. Outside near plate number 2 is this area. So this, for this area, what is the electric field at any point here? So electric field here is in the opposite directions. But which one is greater in magnitude here? 1 or 2? 2 is greater in magnitude. So the direction, net direction, will be anyway downwards only. When we talk about a vector quantity or like force, if there is a 60 newton in positive I cap and 70 newton in negative I cap, so automatically the net force will be 10 newton in negative I cap. Similarly, this is 2 sigma and this is only 1 sigma. So due to the first one only 1 sigma, but due to the second one it is 2 sigma, so it has more electric field intensity. So the net will be downwards. So but what is the magnitude? So for the magnitude, the greater one is 2 sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, and the smaller one is sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So whatever the charge density, you have to write there without using any, you know, positive or negative sign. So you will get sigma upon 2 epsilon naught downwards. So such questions are there in the chapter, and there are many more questions, hundreds of questions you can create like this, because they are concepts. So in the third region, this region also you can find easily. So that's all about this module, and you have to practice the derivations first, memorize the formulas like this, so that you will be able to do the conceptual questions and numericals. And so in the next module we'll be learning chapter 2, that is electrostatic potential and potential energy in capacitance. So that's all.